So it's going to say writing trunking.md. So it's writing something. All right, there we go. This is the blog post here. Wow, this is a little bit more detailed than I expected, but that looks nice. And then it says I've created the blog post and saved it as trunking.md in the writing folder. And you know, the thing is, because I have this within context, I can continue to iterate on this right here. Hey everyone. So I wanted to share a little bit on some use cases that I've been exploring using Gemini CLI. So what I'm going to do is I'm just going to hit Gemini here, and this will open Gemini CLI for me. And here is just doing the authentication part. And notice that it has access to these four MCP servers. Okay, so four of them. So I'm going to hit here Control T. And this will show you all of the MCP tools that I've been using. So I've been experimenting with a few of them. I have a few of them for things like analyzing PDF files. The other one that I use a lot is this transcription MCP server that I've built. And this one has two different tools. One is to transcribe YouTube videos, and the other one is to transcribe local videos. Local videos would be things that are stored in my local machine. So I do a lot of video recording for YouTube, for videos on X. I also do a lot of recording for my academy, which I do record a lot of courses and lessons. A very useful set of tools for me right now is transcription. And this is because I want to make my courses more accessible, and all of my videos I want to make more accessible. This one about YouTube is sometimes I enjoy looking at some YouTube videos and I want to transcribe the video to summarize essentially what that YouTube video is talking about instead of actually watching the entire YouTube video. So I use this less, but this is the one that I'm currently using for some of my work. This particular MCP tool is using Gemini 2.5 Pro, the thinking model for generating transcriptions. Specifically, it is generating SRT files. This is something that I recently built. While the SRT files that it's generating are not perfect, I think they're very close to being perfect, and they're pretty accurate from what I can tell on most of the videos that I'm transcribing. So I want to show you here within Gemini CLI what that process would look like. So why do I need to use Gemini CLI when I could maybe hook something like this into, say, like a web application, or into like Cursor, or even something like Windsurf? Well, I work a lot with the CLI. In fact, I do most of my work in CLI, the work that includes a lot of coding and scripting and so on. This is my home, right? This is the place where I spend most of my time. So I'm using Gemini for analyzing code bases, closing PRs on some of our open source projects and so forth. So sometimes I just want to do some other work, and this work would include like the transcription. It could also include things like generating some blog posts from these transcriptions as well. So I want to show you that process here and how that might work. So these are kind of creative use cases of how to use Gemini CLI for other things beyond coding. So let me just do here transcribe, and then I'm just going to paste. And this is just a directory. This is a path to one of the lessons for my introduction to RAD courses. I have all the folders in here. And because Gemini CLI operates as an agentic system, I could literally ask it to iterate over all the videos here as well, but I won't do that. It has access to the directories. It has access to all of these files. So for now, I'm not interested in doing that. I just want to do it for one video. So this is the video that I chose. This is the MP4 video on chunking. So I'm going to submit that, and then it's going to say, it usually says something really funny here. It's going to ask me if I want to execute this tool or if I should allow it. I will say yes, always allow. And now it's going to do the transcription. Again, as a reminder, this tool specifically is going to use the Gemini APIs, specifically Gemini 2.5 Pro. So it's like Gemini CLI using and leveraging an MCP server that include tools that are built on top of Gemini API. So that's pretty meta. But anyways, that's kind of how I build these MCP tools. Here, I'm going to show you the results in a bit. So it's taking a few seconds. And this is generally very fast because my videos are usually very short. Okay, there it is. So this is the full SRT file, right? It's just the SRT text. It's not the file itself, but I can actually tell it to save this file into some folder. Since it has access to my directory, I can tell it something like save the SRT file as chunking.srt inside the, I have a folder called writing. Okay, there it is. Into the writing folder. It's going to store that SRT file inside that folder. So just going to hit enter here, and it says it's going to read the many files. Again, it's just reading stuff. Again, it behaves like an agent, and it's going to read the directory. And it says that there are two files here, so that's great. It actually read those. There are just two files here that I have as an example. And then it's just going to write the SRT file right there. So that's pretty much usable wherever I want to use it. These are going to be used directly into some of my course videos to offer subtitles for some of our courses, which a lot of users really like. So, okay, so it says apply these changes. Here, I'm going to say, yes, I always allow. So now it's going to write the file, then says I've saved the transcription as chunking.srt in the writing directory. I can confirm that it is actually written. So you can see here the chunking.srt file, and that's inside of the writing directory. So that exists. Let me go back here into Gemini CLI. So I want to do a few other things that I actually do in a day-to-day basis. So sometimes an idea pops up and I'm like, okay, I want to write like a little blog post about this. I think that would be interesting. Some other way in how I can reuse this content. So I can tell it something like, can you please generate a nice technical blog post for this and store the result inside of the writing folder as chunking.md. Again, because Gemini CLI operates as an agent, it's going to first generate a technical blog post, and then it's going to store that as a file called chunking.md. MD is the format I use for most of my writing, and it's going to store it within this folder. So there's a couple of things that it actually needs to do. And this is the power of agentic systems, right? This is what I want to show here, how easy and how productive tools like this can make you with day-to-day work. So you can see this was the last file that we wrote, the SRT file. So basically, because it has this SRT stuff in context, it's just going to use that. So you can see we have 99% of context left. It's just going to reuse that stuff. I don't really need to present that back to the model. It just knows how to use that because it is within the context of it. So it's going to say writing chunking.md. So it's writing something. All right, there we go. This is the blog post here. Wow, this is a little bit more detailed than I expected, but that looks nice. And then it says, I've created the blog post and saved it as chunking.md in the writing folder. And you know, the thing is, because I have this within context, I can continue to iterate on this right here. Similarly, if I wanted to do some edits on this SRT file, I could probably do it within the context as well. So that's really great, right? You can do multiple things here. This is an agentic system at the end of the day, so it has access to everything that it needs and all the tools and the resources it needs to get this important work done. And it's just increased the productivity that I have in my work. All right, so let's look at the chunking.md. So I just open up the chunking.md. You can see that it's in this folder here. And this is basically what it wrote. From here, you know, this is easy now. I can just go and take this, put it into like my Substack, wherever I want to post this, or convert this also into a tweet. So I could pretty much tell it here to produce a tweet from this as well if I wanted for social media content as well. So there's no limitations. As long as you have it within the context, you can continue in the session and you can continue working on the stuff. And, you know, you can get pretty creative as well. You can ask Gemini to do more with this stuff. And it's just keeping track of all the session and everything that you're doing. So it's pretty smart about all the outputs that it's giving you on every iteration and every turn. One last thing I wanted to share here within Gemini CLI. So when I actually close the session, you know, I quit the session here, you can also choose to memorize things or ask Gemini CLI to memorize things, and you can reuse that in the next session. Another thing though that the Gemini CLI can do, so it can collect some stats about your session, right? So in this case, it called these amount of tools, right? How much was the success rate and so forth, the wall time, the model usage, Gemini 2.5 Pro, you can see there are 6 requests. The input tokens were 81,000, output tokens were 2.7K. And then down here, it says, very interesting, it says savings highlight 40,569, 49.6 of input tokens were served from the cache, reducing costs. So Gemini has this thing that it also can cache. This is a new feature that was introduced recently, and Gemini CLI, the agent, can take advantage of that. So that's another benefit. Besides all the creative stuff that we did within Gemini CLI, we also get these benefits as well. So this is another area that I'm really excited about, efficient use of the context window and finding interesting ways on how to make the system more efficient and less costly as well. So that's another, I think, area of exploration. I'll be sharing more about this stuff and how I do context engineering within Gemini CLI as well and some other tools. And so stay tuned for that, and I'll see you all in the next one.